I'm Deborah Johnson, and this is Keys to the Keyboard. Would you like to play along with a simple lead sheet, or would you like to accompany yourself while you're singing a song and being able to play a simple piano part, or understand the basics of piano chords and accompaniment and how they work together in different keys? If you'd like to do some of that, this is for you. I'm not going to train you to be a concert pianist, and if you want to go that direction, good for you, good for you. It will take a lot more study, but I'm going to focus on some of the basics. Especially, I have some friends that are able to sing and able to do even a lot of things on the piano classically, but they're not familiar with their chords and how they work together in playing a simple song. I'm going to start in this introduction with some of the very basics to make sure that we're all on the same page. With the piano fingers first. Your piano fingers, we start with the thumb, with number one. One, two, three, four, five. They go out. Now on your guitar, it's different. If you're a guitar player, you start with the one finger, like your index finger. One, two, three, four. But piano fingers are different. Now, I'm using, for demonstration purposes, I'm using a very light and cheap keyboard, because many people come to a point in their life where they have downsized. They've gotten rid of their grandmother's grand piano or upright piano, some of those very heavy pianos, which I love, by the way. I do have a grand piano and I have larger keyboards, but I'm demonstrating on this small keyboard because many have a keyboard just like this in their house. And I want you to know that you can learn really everything you need to know in this program on a keyboard like this. It's very light, very lightweight. The keys are light. They're not weighted down. They're not heavy. And your grand piano, your acoustic pianos, most of them are going to be a little stiffer to be able to play. So hopefully, eventually, you'll be able to get on some acoustic pianos, because that would be very, very good for your finger strength. So we have our five fingers. One, two, three, four, five. And let's talk about how we play with our actual finger position as well. You want to be able to play on the pad of your finger. This gets into the nail length. You know, I know many love to have beautiful long nails, and good for you. Good for you. But when you're playing piano, it's nice to be able to play on that pad of the finger and not hear that clicking of the nails. It's very, very bothersome. It's kind of like those nails on a chalkboard to me. But that's, if you really are serious about this, you want to be able to have just nice, groomed, shorter, a little shorter nails. You also want to be able to play with a level wrist. Now, that doesn't mean up, doesn't mean down very far, but level wrist. You'll see me, I'm playing standing up because for demonstration purposes, but when I am practicing, when I'm working on my acoustic piano and I'm seated, my wrist is level and relaxed. The arms are relaxed. Now, many wonder, okay, I don't know if I can play the piano because my hands are so small. Now, my hands actually reach just an octave. I can go above that just a tiny bit. An octave is like from a C to a C, a D to a D. Those are octaves, all right? The famous classical pianist wrote wonderful, wonderful pieces that we enjoy called Rachmaninoff. He is, it said that he had the reach of like a 13th, which is above an octave and a fifth. Those are like huge hands. I call them banana hands. They're huge, bigger than most basketball players today. They're huge hands. You do not have to have hands that big. Actually, they could probably just get in the way. So if you can reach even an octave, you're good. You can do everything you need to right here. And this also is the smaller keyboard, the 61 key. There's a 76 key and an 88 key. Doesn't really matter what you start on, they'll have fewer octaves up and down. Also, I have a couple items here called pedals. Now, for this particular keyboard, I'm going to use this little square pedal. It's a Yamaha. The keyboard is also a Yamaha. And that works great. You might come into, if you're ordering online, it'll say positive and negative polarity. You don't have to worry about that too much anymore. It may have a little button on it, but usually these work just fine. This one looks more like an acoustic piano pedal. I use it on my larger keyboard called a Kurzweil keyboard. There's many weighted keyboards. I really enjoy the Kurzweil. And it's one with more of a spring action and very close to the acoustic piano as well. The acoustic piano, you'll see, has two or three pedals down on the floor. Most grand pianos have three. The left one is your soft pedal, and the right one is your sustain pedal, and that's exactly what this is. It will hold, it will sustain the notes. Now, the last thing that I like to say in the introduction is to encourage you to have a regular time of practice. I only ask at the beginning for like 15 minutes a day, 5 days a week. If you can be as consistent with that, with the repetition to work into your practice, you will learn. As Coach John Wooden said, practice doesn't make perfect, but perfect practice makes perfect. So just that 15 minutes a day can move you ahead and learn all the things that really you need to know to accompany yourself for a simple accompaniment, for lead sheets, for some of the singing that you want to do. You can learn. So here we go on our Keys to the Keyboard. I hope you enjoy as much as I will.